here we go in the Women's Championship of the 2014 U.S. Open. As we've seen with Serena Williams, she's won the last two, but they haven't been easy.
For sets, Serena Williams is off. Ready. Play.
Wondering why does this match start when it starts? This is Football Sunday in America. That's a very big deal. And the CBS network has the 1 o'clock games. They wrap up shortly after four, and here we are. Chanda, not to drop names, but I'll do it anyway. Came up on the elevator with Martina Navratilova. She told me that she thinks Wozniacki has to win the first set.
I would agree with that. I think that is the best chance.
Oh!
I think she has to get a good start as well. And that's going to be imperative here. In the last match from Serena against Makarova was this type of play. Serena looking to be aggressive and attack the midcourt area. And that's when Serena is doubly dangerous. She's coming in and trying to take balls out of the air.
Shadows could be a little bit of an issue here in the first few minutes.
And I think for Wozniacki, along with getting a good start, she has trouble breaking serves. She needs to do everything she can to hold and just keep that ball deep and keep it moving.
We haven't seen Serena's big first serve yet. She's gotten in a 99. That was out, but it was 119.
Outlasting her opponent. She kept that ball deep there. Hits the air.
Break point.
That's a good one. 114 out wide.
Yes.
Very well placed.
I love watching great players get to a moment when they just have a little something extra. Chanda, here's a question for you. Will Wozniacki go for winners in this match?
I think she'll go for a little bit more, and at times she will need to go for winners in this match. But that's not her game, to just go for winners in the middle stages of points.
Figures out her first serve. Confidently wins the game.
First game.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh. in the crowd. That's just one of the shots that separates Serena.
It's almost like a bomb going off when you hear the ball hit the racket the way it does when Serena hits it that solidly. It's powerful. Basic first serve is better than the best second serve. Wozniacki able to withstand that mini barrage.
Second serve wasn't really close. I guess she feels pressure. She's that the second serve's got to have something.
Well, those last two hits from Serena, first point and even the second point, Wozniacki got it back, but Serena got such a clean hit in that ball. Serena missed that shot. That's continuing to put pressure on Wozniacki on her serve. She knows she can't just lay that serve in. Caused a couple of double faults in this game. Wozniacki's father. Miss from Serena, and that's what Wozniacki has made a living off of.
Key moment, kaboom.
Serena, she's accepted the challenge of hitting out on these returns. She's missed a few early, but when they start to flow, they are unreturnable.
That is just spectacular. Early service game. That is a break, and that could be Serena's ticket here in the first set.
And that's the pressure that you feel from Serena. And Wozniacki doesn't have a big serve, and those second serves just sat up in her strike zone.
Looks dialed in.
And the placement on that serve was outstanding.
Could you ever play a tennis match for $4 million? $4 million. That's what Serena's doing here.
That's a career of earnings for some players.
Thank you.
the open court. Serena moved in perfectly. Just dropped the racket head at the very end.
How about this stat? Not all stats are created equal. The last 19 U.S. Open champions have all won the first set.
Wow.
Right?
That's telling.
Oh!
Okay, now the last time Serena faced a break point, she unleashed the Master Blaster. So the service break for Wozniacki, but did she really win the game, or did Serena just mistake it to her?
Service game, you know, Serena was playing a pretty clean match, and from 30 love, she made four straight errors, and that bumped her total love to errors, and gave Wozniacki the game, got her on the board. Wozniacki has to hope for is Serena may go off a little bit, go on a walkabout or give her some errors in the teeth of the match, and hopefully she can take advantage of that as she did in that last game. And I also think Wozniacki, she can outlast Serena in a few points as well, and that could turn the tide if Serena lets her into the match. And again, from love 30, a couple of errors from Serena. And those are the type of mistakes that Wozniacki doesn't make.
Wozniacki solves the first serve. It's got to be a tough way to play tennis, Chanda.
Well, it's nice when you can win a point that way. Wozniacki has won very few points thus far. From Serena for the most part. And again, here, Serena kicks it up a gear, gets that focus back, and gives herself big margins.
Deuce. chance for Serena Williams to break again. It was a 92 mile an hour serve that Serena just crushed.
With it, and it worked there. 1-2 punch, and she needs to move forward whenever she can. That's a high percentage play. Likes it. Staying disciplined here, Serena. Taking that ball out of the air. That's a great play. This looks easy. This looks pretty simple, but it is not. It is textbook, done extremely well. Great timing, extension on that, and the power.
And Serena gets the break right back to go up 3-1 in this first set.
Wozniacki was in that game, and she had opportunities. She will just have to continue to scramble and fight and compete within points.
Follow the U.S. Open at usopen.org. Check out their Twitter and Facebook accounts as well. First serve percentage?
Still very low, 27%. She's only made 4 first serves. His first couple of serve games. That got to one in the world. She is so tough. Gets to that extra ball, makes you win the point over and over.
Serena's miscues are allowing Caroline Wozniacki to hang around. Triple break point to get this match back on serve. Serena mistakes her way to give the serve back on serve in the first set.
Errors, but it's been more the timing of those unforced errors.
U.S. Open champion Andy Roddick at the match today. Wozniacki's last serve at 86 miles an hour.
To focus on making that first serve as she did there, and then here and there throwing in the bigger serves. That serve was hit pretty well. Good pace, but it came back even quicker. And that's the danger for Wozniacki. Doesn't want to hit herself or serve her way out of the point. Serena does get the break. She leads 4-2. Well, you know, it has to be a frustrating first set for both players. For both players, but particularly for Caroline Wozniacki, because she isn't in control for the most part. Serena, surprising, she's lost her serve twice in a row. We wouldn't have said that. But it's on her racket. And 32% first serves, there's a big improvement that's possible. You know that. You know what's going on out there. You know if Serena just pulls it together a little bit on her serve, you may have no chance in these games. Trying to go for just a little bit more. Serena Williams coaching consultant Patrick Muratoglu on the right hand of the screen. Sasha Bayin, her hitting partner, on the left.
One of the most exciting places to be at the U.S. Open is outside the women's locker room after Serena has won. the crowd of people waiting to meet her and take pictures with her is astounding. Big basketball players like Kevin Garnett, some of the most famous rappers in the world, designers, they all want their Serena moment. But she has said, I didn't do this to become a star. I did this to win.
She doesn't mind being a star, too.
I'm sure it's a pretty nice package. Great backhand, and she couldn't follow it up with another one. And Serena's in control here in the opening set, 5-2. It's good. Why not? It's a whisker job. That's why it looked out to her.
Can't get a break.
No. Actually tried to force the issue by going to the limit of the court. Is it too late here?
It's tough because for Wozniacki, she has to do more in these points than she's really comfortable doing. It's caused a few more unforced errors. She's already at 7 for the match. Only one winner.
Going to take the advice.
It's out.
And the problem for Wozniacki, as well as the only times their matches have been close, is when Wozniacki has won the first set. She's still more often than not lost the match, but that's the only way she's been able to compete, and she's in real trouble here.
30 all.
40.
Wozniacki now making some basic errors, and that's just the pressure that Serena is putting her under.
And we come now off the Wozniacki error to set point.
Thank you.
Struck backhand, and she has to go for those shots just to stay in points.
And whatever she did on that first serve, try and do it again.
It was well placed, only 99 miles per hour.
Oh!
Wozniacki holds, but that won't prevent Serena Williams from serving for the set.
Williams leads 5 games to 3.
That's a good hold, though, to finally win her serve, Wozniacki. The end of the set, give you a little more positive energy.
But we haven't seen the best of Serena yet.
We haven't yet. I'm sure that's what's worrying Wozniacki still. Second ball, Wozniacki keeping it deep, going for the lanes. And Serena comes back with a serve like that, and that's what's frustrating for Wozniacki. She plays a great point, and then it's negated. Difficult shot, took her time, concentrate on her contact point.
What does it tell you that she took it out of the air?
Well, she's confident, Serena, and wanting to be aggressive.
30-15.
That's why that serve is such a weapon. Even with the low percentage of first serves right now, when you can come up with that kind of serve.
Wozniacki says no, it was called good.
And the chair called it out.
Okay. Training for the New York City Marathon got going there in that game, and Serena converts. The first set is hers, and history at the U.S. Open says that's a big deal.
Well, the reason why Serena can still be on top with 16 unforced errors is because she can also hit winners at will. She has 15 winners to offset those errors, and then there's the forced errors like that last one. Wozniacki on that changeover in the chair. She was a little bit dejected. Look, she was slumped over a little bit for most of the sit down and looked very contemplative. And this is the struggle for her, how to get into these games and try to dictate.
That's just great play at the net. How do you dictate when that's not your game plan?
It's extremely difficult, and 15-15. In some cases, she can't, as in that last point. There was nothing she could do, and even here, Serena was a little late getting in, but Wozniacki still couldn't make her pay. Hit a beautiful volley there. But it's not her game. was one of the more solid points from Wozniacki. Really worked to stay in this point and hang in there. And then another demoralizing shot there.
Long rally dominated by Serena's hitting. The second set with a similar tone to the first set. Service break.
You look at Wozniacki and that the point that ended that last game. She hit a nice serve out wide, but she went back cross court. When Serena stretched out, she wasn't willing to go up the line. Those are the little things she has to be willing to do to dictate in points. Serena can do that. And she can take control. So you have to take your openings when they're there.
She consolidates the break. First serve looked pretty good in this game.
Slowly she's finding that first serve. In this game, she made three quarters of her first serves, and they weren't just made. She did something with them. You have to wonder what's going through Caroline Wozniacki's mind right now. How do you find a way to hang in this match and try to turn the second set around?
Oh, she pretty much have to play in a way that we haven't seen, right?
She would have to play inspired, unbelievable tennis. And she played great tennis against Irani, but a completely different ball in completely different challenges. Taking that ball up the line, taking your lanes when they open up. If you miss that opportunity, it sometimes doesn't come again in a point against Serena. Wozniacki didn't do anything really wrong at that point. Where do you go from there?
Serena being Serena, right?
you just pick up, poor girl, can you just pick up the piece of red? Thanks.
That was trouble. She threw it in at 73 miles per hour. That ball set right in the middle of the box. Didn't move Serena.
Back to deuce.
She would have been able to stay in this point. She would have been in pretty good position. But against Serena, who just kicks it up a notch, just can't catch up.
You know, she kept probing to that corner of the court and then just got better and better and better. Break point.
So you have to hope, if you're Wozniacki, for a few errors like that one. A few opportunities to try to squeeze games out of this match. It's a little better court position for Wozniacki. She was trying to stay on that baseline, not give up ground. That's another way for her to try to take time away from Serena.
Look at that. One winner, 11 unforced errors.
That's a big problem.
Yeah.
Game, Wozniacki.
Wozniacki holds serve.
Williams leads to game 2-1, second
Serena
set.
Williams serving 2-1, second set in the women's final.
Wozniacki may have another sunset in her. Get another break of serve here.
That gives her hope.
That could help. Thus far.
She was going for something there.
Well, she was, but that's the shot that is somewhat foreign to Wozniacki. Playing a little outside of her comfort zone.
Oh. 40-15.
Thank you.
7 seconds.
You can't overstate the ability of Serena to turn a point around with one swing of the racket.
Hey, check out usopenshop.org. Follow the U.S. Open on Twitter or on their Facebook page. A lot of great-looking souvenirs.
Where Serena was so dominant, she was expected to just run right through Victoria Azarenka.
Yeah, remember how tight that match got?
It started that way, and it got so tight, Azarenka found a way to get into it. Now, this feels very different because Wozniacki has different skills than Azarenka. Doesn't quite have the depth, doesn't quite have the ability to dictate enough.
So this, in effect, is Wozniacki 2.0. This is supposed to be her second coming at the age of 24, but it's surprising to me she comes back with a game that looks a lot like it did when she was number one.
Well, it hasn't changed a whole lot. She's doing some things better. That Serena represents, and it's difficult for her to catch her breath, and that's what she needs when she plays.
Sitting behind Dad is Anna Wozniacki, Caroline's mom. Better serving moments for Caroline Wozniacki in the match, but Serena is still up a break here in what could be the deciding second set. Sixth ace of the match for Serena Williams. Fastest serve is 120, that was 116.
Match at times, because when Serena misses, Wozniacki gets into the point, into the match. When she doesn't, Wozniacki's out of it.
Yeah. Serena's taking a little something off her serve, I think, to get it in, and there is one of tennis's great legends, Virginia Wade, who lives in New York.
Two seconds in.
When you have a player that can be that dominant on serve, and your Caroline Wozniacki who doesn't have a huge serve, it puts so much more pressure on that shot. And this is where, you know, she's worked on her serve, Wozniacki. She's serving with a little more force. She's trying to control the play with her serve. You know, but there's not a lot of room for her.
Well, the last service game was better, though, right?
It was much better. But she has to serve almost unbelievable for her.
Yeah.
For Wozniacki right now, she needs to work more on moving that serve, really trying to hit her spots as opposed to trying to worry as much about pace. first couple of points. Give yourself a little bit of breathing room. That was well placed. That serve out wide, getting Serena stretched out on the forehand.
Second consecutive service opportunity. Wozniacki has to leave the court with confidence. Serena serving up a set and 4-3.
I think here Wozniacki needs to take a few more chances on that return. Maybe pick some spots. Sit on that T serve, which Serena loves. She's got to try to go after that serve just a little bit more. She can't afford to just get it back in the court at this stage. Choosing to just get the serve back, use it to start the point. That's a big miss for her right now. Approach from Wozniacki, but it did the job. It made Serena look up, took a little attention off of her ground stroke. Energy up.
Get
some positive energy going. Out doing Serena there.
Points away.
Williams leads 5-3.
Some tennis immortality.
That was just beautiful play by Serena. Textbook.
I know you're going to disagree. I still think Serena has taken a little bit off the gas here in this match. I really do.
At times.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
And I think it's also because she knows she can dictate whenever she wants.
Love it.
I think Serena has started this. this match out, hitting the ball, going for her shots, finding her range so that in the teeth of the match, she's confident hitting that ball. Tables,
15-0.
Turning defense into offense with that down the line shot, and then the movement getting back quickly to close off the court.
What a recovery. Crowd doesn't want to go home yet. Everyone in the crowd wants to know why then. What a display of tennis from these two. 26 shots, and about 20 of those from Serena could have been winners.
15-13.
Extreme defensive skills that this woman has.
Quiet, please. Thank you. Please.
Wozniacki couldn't get to that one, and here we stand.
And this is just hardcore tennis from Serena. Got down, accepted the challenge, paid the price, and she was willing to do in that last point.
And this now is a potential moment for Serena to claim her sixth U.S. Open and her 18th Grand Slam.
Ladies and gentlemen, Serena.